Good morning, Professor. It's Diane Cook, and I'm here to do teaching demo lesson number 2, which is part of my unit plan for ancient Egypt. Okay. Our objectives: students will make observations about ancient Egypt's social system. Let's look at this objective, okay? Does anybody know what that means? Students will make observations about ancient Egyptian social system. Does anybody know what that means?
So,
what does observations mean?
So we can know what we're talking about.
Okay, we can learn more about it. Good, okay. We talked about social systems before. Do we know what social systems are?
Social system is when you're using things about people in the social
and how they interact, okay? So it's basically people's roles and how they interact, okay? The language objective, okay? Students will compare the social system of Egypt to our social system today. We're gonna do a little activity after, okay? Everyone knows what our social system is today. Like, you kind of have an idea of our social system, okay? And students will communicate the different roles of Egypt's social structure through role play. So you're gonna do a little activity today. Okay? You're gonna do an active. Okay, so we have a whole list of standards that this follows. First of all, the TESOL-RITA standards is standard 5. Helps communicate information, ideas, and concepts necessary for academic success in the content area of social studies. Then we have the Common Core standards. We have RH 6.7. We're going to be using some visuals to understand everything that we're trying to learn. We're going to look at words and their meanings. SL 6.2, we're going to interpret information in different formats, text and visual. We're going to adapt our speech so that we are demonstrating command of English. And we're going to present claims, sequencing ideas, and using descriptions and details. And then SL 0.1, prepare for and effectively participate in a range of conversations. Okay? This is the boring stuff. Okay, so we're going to start with our lesson. Here's the warm-up, okay? This is our doing now. So I want you to look at this. This is the social structure pyramid of Egypt, of ancient Egypt, okay? So I just want you to look at it, and what do you notice? Who's at the top? Who's at the bottom?
The king.
Because he has more powers than all of them.
So the pharaoh is at the top, correct? Very good. Because he has a lot of power, right? Yeah. Who comes next?
The government.
Good. Do we have a pharaoh in our right now? Do we have a pharaoh?
No,
right? Who do we have that kind of makes
president.
The president? Okay. And our government officials, like senators, things like that. So we have some things that are in the same. Who comes next?
The soldiers,
right? And then we have?
The scribes.
And?
The merchants, the craftsmen, and the farmers and slaves.
So, if they're at the bottom,
that means
if somebody's at the bottom, what does that mean?
That means they have less power.
Good. So, if somebody's at the top, they have a lot of power. And if somebody's at the bottom, they don't have so much power, right? And it gets less and less as we go through. Okay. Okay, so this is what we're going, this is activity number 2, that was activity number 1. So activity number 2, we are going to read about the different roles that we just looked at, okay? And I'm going to give each of you, first I'm going to do a model, I'm going to do the spinner and the weaver, I'm going to read through it, and then I'm going to think to myself, how would a spinner and a weaver act? What would they do? Then you're gonna do the same thing at your seat. And then you're gonna come up and you're gonna act it out. You're gonna come up and act out your role, okay? So Ms. Cook's gonna go first. She's going to read through it very quickly. As a spinner or a weaver, you're part of a group of workers known as craftsmen or trade workers in modern terms. Both men and women perform this job. Your duties as a spinner is to tease a few fibers from a large ball of flax, fibers, and spin the fibers together until you create a single thread. As a weaver, you work with a loom to transform the spun flax thread into linen cloth. You represent a middle-class member of society. You are higher than slaves and farmers, but below priests and scribes. Still, your work is valued as you make the finest linens for the pharaoh down to coarse cloths for ordinary peasants. Other craft workers include jewelers, carpenters, and stone workers. So I need to think to myself, how would this person act? What would they do? Okay? So a person who is a they're higher than slaves, so they have some kind of, you know, prestige, you know, they're on the pyramid. But they also have to work with little pieces of fiber. So I have these props that I brought in for everyone today. So I'm going to act out what a weaver would do putting it together, okay? That's what they would do. And they have to make stuff for the pharaoh. So the pharaoh is the most important person in Egypt. So they're going to make sure that it's perfect, okay? So he makes linens for the pharaoh, okay? And he also makes cloths for ordinary peasants, right? So that's kind of, they're important people in Egyptian society. So what I would do after that, I would sit down and I would act out what they would do. So we have an order for the pharaoh. We have to make sure that our work is perfect. Let me take this piece of string and put everything together so the pharaoh is close and he looks as important as he is. Okay, so that would be the end of the role play. So then I would give this group of students is going to be a scribe, so I'd like you guys to read that together. You're working in pairs. Okay, and you two are going to be the pharaoh. You're going to act like a pharaoh. I provided it in French for you if you need it for translation. So, after the students do their role play, okay, we would. Can we pause that? Oh, no.
Mm-hmm.